In Game 3, Toronto knew it would have to face Dominik Hasek, and the theory was simple. Get under his skin to keep him out of your head. Get under his skin. Keep him out of our head. The anatomy of a game plan, round one to the Dominator.
CBC, Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Labatt Blue. A whole lot can happen out of the blue. And by Ford. For now, forever.
Buffalo has just hit the ice. The Toronto Maple Leafs, Game 4 of the Eastern Conference Championship Final. Buffalo leading 2-1. If you didn't know anything about hockey, you'd think this was some kind of a cult show. Marina is rocking. There's no question about that. Two lineup changes tonight. If you've not heard, Rob Ray is in for Buffalo. That has nothing to do with the shenanigans at the end of game number 3 when Ty Domi was involved with Dominik Hasek and said Wayne Primeau has a knee injury. He was in a collision with Chris King. Primeau can't go, so Rob Ray gets the chance to suit up for the home side. Adam Mayer, a 20-year-old youngster who broke into the NHL playing his first ever game in the playoffs, scoring in that first ever game. He'll replace Derek King in the Toronto lineup. King is out. That's just Pat Quinn's decision. He didn't feel King was rolling. So the pressure is on Toronto. Keisha Adamchuk will sing to honor our neighboring nations as the Toronto Maple Leafs put it all on the line against the Buffalo Sabres tonight.
And now, join us in the singing of the Canadian and U.S. National Anthems along with 11-year-old Keisha Adamchuk from North Buffalo.
Another sellout, nearly 19,000 here in the building tonight for this game. The Maple Leafs and the Sabres. There's Curtis Joseph. He has to come back with another of his big games to take it to 2-2 before going home for Game 5 on Monday. Curtis Joseph for the Maple Leafs. The Leafs have to beat him 3 of 4 games now to win this series. That's a tall order, beating Dominic Hasek. All the starting lineups come to center ice. Referees for the game will be Mark Fawcett, number 11, and Jerry Gregson, number 4. Gord Rossiger and Dan Shepney will work the lines. Pekka, Virata, Ward, Schmelik, and Jetnik starting for Buffalo. Yuskevich, Harkov, and on the wings for Toronto, Bohannes and Thomas. And here comes Matt Sundin, the captain, to center ice. So the two captains get ready to start this one. We're underway. Harkov gets to center and shoots it in. On it quickly, Schmelik got it up on the boards. Sabres get it down across center ice and get chase. Rada, though, wasn't there ahead of Yuskevich. This crowd with you on this Saturday night here in Buffalo. The Sabres can get a stranglehold on the series with a win here at home tonight. Haven't lost at home yet in these playoffs. Pekka first shot. Pekka's pass, a wicked pass. And Zhitnik couldn't stop it. It came off the boards like a bullet and all the way down the ice. Schmelik. Turning the play is Schmelik behind the goal. Again, he has to put it back to Zhitnik. Center up over the Leaf line, but the play is called because behind Hasek the net has been moved.
Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs have made one lineup change for tonight. They have put Adam Mayer in, and this is his first shift, and you can see he gets a hold of Richard Schmelik with a nice body check and knocks him into the net. It causes the whistle. Let's have a look at the Leaf lineup. We're going with the same six defensemen. Côté played more than any other defenseman in Game 3. And Adam Mayer will sit in there in Derek King's spot with Adams and Johnson.
Faceoff comes to the right of Curtis Joseph. Brown at center now for Buffalo. Sullivan won it for the Leafs. Lead pass gets to the line. Sullivan was moving up there, but it didn't get to him. Johnson fires it in there on the left side. Sullivan gets the zone, comes in, fake the shot, dumped it over in front, and the Sabres quickly turn it back. Three of them come to center. Rolled in on the right wing. Chetan feeding it back in front of the net. But Brown was tied up. He's still there behind the goal with Carpentier on him. Chetan comes in to help. Carpentier, the defenseman for Toronto, moved it away quickly. And the Leafs get out, looking for that first goal. Dominic Hasek just slipping that one to the right. And the Sabres get going. Chetan's pass. Knocked away from inside the line. And there goes Gary Ball. He dumps it in. Hasek was out, but he couldn't stop it behind the goal. Junot trying to pick it up for Buffalo. Up the line. Away with Junot. And three of them come up on the two-leaf defenseman. The pass gets rated through. And Ball, good back checking. Picked it off. Marner. Up the center with it. That's a chance. Gustafsson. First big scoring chance. And Joseph stopped him. Hero now for Toronto. Flipped it over the line for Berezin. A little bit too far. Gustafsson again. In goes Junot. His pass. That was broken up. And cleared by Perreault. The Leafs want to make changes. ADP. Hit on the boards, and Ray was caught with that one.
Well, the Buffalo Sabres have to make one change, not on defense. McKee has really come into his own as a young defenseman on this Sabre team, but you're going to see Ray is in, and Wayne Primeau is out. Primeau hurt his knee in the third period in Game 3. I talked with him this morning. He hopes to be back within a week, but he says it's pretty tender. So the tough guy, Rob Ray, will take Primeau's spot.
Here comes the face-off to the right of Dominic Hasek. No No shot for him yet. And no score. Nearing the 3-minute mark, the puck is down the ice again. Yuskevich is coming back. And Ray is right after him. He was hit by Groshek, and now the net behind Joseph is off. Let's see it on the moment. Now they do.
Well, the net's off again. The second time in the first 3 minutes that a whistle has gone because the net is knocked off. That's a pretty good indication that both teams intend to get people without the puck going to the net. And the Buffalo Sabres have done this pretty well the entire playoff, and it's an area of the game for Toronto that they want them to improve. As you see, Groshek at the back of the net and knocked it off. Rosick was a healthy scratch for the last couple of games against Boston and the first couple against Toronto. A talented guy. Not always do you get it every night from him.
9 seconds short of the 3 minutes into the first period. In game four in Buffalo. Pekka on again for the Sabres. Won the draw into the corner. Parada in there first. Got it behind the goal. That's Sundin. Bohannes waited for it. Did get it out over the line, barely. Jimmick's quick pass. The center, the Leafs trying to stop Pekka. He's coming hard to the net. And Joseph stops him. A great burst of speed by Mike Pekka. And Joseph made another big stop.
We now move ahead in the action.
So now at 11:12 of the period, a power play for Buffalo.
He and Ray get together right here, and it comes out a holding penalty. Not too often you see these two guys get called for holding, but there's the hold as Domi pins Ray, and now the Buffalo Sabres with a power play. 5-for-17 in this series get a chance to go ahead.
That's what you call a hot power play.
Don Lever, the assistant coach, is in charge of the power play, and it has worked to almost perfection in the playoffs.
Yuskevich shoots it from center. The Sabres will come back now and try to get organized and come after the Maple Leafs for the first goal of the game. 8:30 remaining in the first. Now here they come. Pekka dumps it in. Yuskevich hit hard on the boards in the corner, but not hard enough. Stop at the line by Jimmick. Pekka sets it up. In the corner, he goes to the net. Chatan, bad pass. And the Maple Leafs fired down at Hasek. Johnson just fired it and skated to the bench. Penalty time, 1:15 left. Chatan shoots it in, and there's Curtis Joseph. He'll flip it away. And he came out about, 40, 45 feet. And I said, no, I'm going to lose this race. And he scampered back. He did get back in time.
He, more than any other goalie in the league, will race out of the net 40, 50 feet if you think you get the puck. He's a great skater. And it's one reason why he's an excellent goalie. He can recover. We know all about his balance in the goal race.
Substitution of the goaltender.
Faceoffs at center ice because on the penalty delay, Buffalo cheated on the substitution.
All right, Buffalo gets this on right away. Brown has a man in front of the net. Now he's covered. Back to the line. Sanderson, high shot, rebound. And it's stopped before it gets to Joseph. And the Leafs clear it down the ice. Domi's penalty is over now. He's out of the box. 1:35 left in the other penalty to Adams. Sabres, two power plays in a row now, and the Leafs trying to improve in the penalty killing department. They're doing that so far. Ball shoots that gun. No score. 6:30 left in the period. 1:20 left in the power play. Buffalo. Sabres up to center ice. Sanderson gets his own. Over on the boards and decides to go back to the line with it and get open himself. Let the puck slide to the corner. There's Sanderson again. Feeding it ahead along the boards. They want him to shoot, but not from that angle. This angle, maybe. And Markov made a good play, knocking it to the corner. Chatan trying to get it out front. Markov is there again. Buffalo Sabres are on the puck in there. But the Leafs are fighting hard to kill off these two penalties. And look at that. It's cleared down the ice by Barrison. 42 seconds left in the power play, Buffalo. A big lift for Toronto, I think, if they can kill these two off. They've got one guy, the Domi penalty. Now this one, Adams. And it's Holzinger getting the zone. Turning it back, it's intercepted again. And Bolt cleared it down the ice. There's Hasek. 40 feet out of the net once more. Nearly got caught. Another penalty coming. Yes, sir, it's an interference call.
I think Hasek's going to get
this
one.
Yes, he is.
He loves to come out and make you take the long route to get back into the play. And on this one, there was a collision involved. And so Dominik Hasek, who wanders a lot more than most goalies, gets rid of the puck. Now watch him. He backs into Johnson. It's a pleasant, peaceful body check. But the problem is Johnson can't go where he wants to go after he's made Hasek shoot it.
And he hasn't played the puck.
Well, there you are. And he looks over his shoulder. Mike Johnson does. If you live by the sword, often you die by it. And Dominik Hasek gets an interference call. 19 seconds left in Adams. Chatan sticks her up. Punch right in the mouth by Markov. No penalty. And then Chatan, another elbow by Markov. Chatan's had enough of that. And the referee's trying to let them play without filing too many penalties, but they're strict on the goaltenders.
So far, the penalties have been about goaltenders. This one, to a goaltender. Dominik Hasek. Minor penalty for interference, and Groshek will be in the box to serve. 5:25 left to play in the first period. No score. Leafs win the draw. Quick shot. Hasek had the angle on that. Ferrari just flicked it wrist style. And he catches the goalie, maybe on the wrong foot. But not so. Battle on the boards. Leaf player down. And quick and he broke away. Now he will move. As the Sabres bring it in. Schmeck guarded over in front. And the Leafs pick it up. Lead pass to Sundin. Didn't see it in time. Joseph with a high catch. 4:55 left in the period. Toronto, power play. Up they come. Sundin carries his time. Oh, what a bad pass. It's Pekka coming in alone. Right in. Stopped. He was stopped by Berard, who made a beautiful effort to come back and stop Michael Pekka. Sundin this time to the right wing with it. Down to the left side. Mohannes waits. Mohannes again. Moving up a step or two. Mohannes trying to feed it behind the net. Thomas gets it on the boards to the line. Into Thomas. He waits. He's caught. And the shot is blocked. Bird farted all right, but way on Holzinger. Down up toward. inside the Leaf blue line with 41 seconds left in the penalty that was called on Dominic Hasek.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If you had to nominate a Leaf defenseman to recover when it looked like the opposition were getting a breakaway, it would be Berard. Peck is not a great skater, but he's a very good one. And Berard catches him with a brilliant defensive play at the last minute as Michael Pekka jumped on a Sundin turnover and nearly turned it into a shorthanded goal.
That is definitely the strength of Ryan Berard, that skating ability. He's a beautiful skater, and he demonstrated for you right there with an effort to get back and stop Pekka and possibly the first goal of the game. Good play by Berard. 4 minutes left of the period. 35 seconds on the Leaf power play. Connolly beats it in the wing. Cote comes to the net. Hasek made the stick save. Shot is tipped on the ice. He steps. Another break.
Joseph to open up, and the puck went right through because he had no angle. Here's the hesitation. He looks up, and then there it is, just enough to get Joseph to move, and slides it underneath Joseph's stick in between his legs. A very fine, nifty goal by Dixon Ward. And here's what Joseph looked at. The little fake. Watch him open up. There it is.
Here come the Leafs now. Sullivan. He had to turn back from the checker. Pass to Coverley, knocked it down. Sullivan got in front. Couldn't get his shot through. Short-handed goal by Ward. At 16:15. The goalie Hasek got an assist along with McKee. 1-0 Buffalo. Oh, they're back at full strength now. Fell. They'll handle it though. On that prone position. Johnson picks it up in the corner. Slides it pass ahead of the Leafs skate out. Sullivan turned back. Now his pass is intercepted. And the Sabres shoot it out. Joseph has been beaten. On the 12th shot of the period by Buffalo. Dixon Ward fooled him with a low shot. 1-0 Sabres. Come the Sabres again. Pass to Holzinger. He's galloping in there. Trying to get a shot and turn back with it. Dropped it off to the boards. Larner feeds it behind the net. Sabres pressure again. Sabres leading 1-0 and looking for more. And they're good at it. And the poise behind the net. Shoots Junot in front. He hit a skate. Junot again. Backed it up a bit. Larner was hit. And the Leafs move it out. Against Toronto, 1:55 left in the period.
Dominic Hasek, the Leafs complained, came out of the crease on the icing as if to play the puck. And that now, this year, means they waved the icing off. But for some reason, they didn't. And the Leafs, are, as a result, will have a face-off in their own end to the left of Curtis Joseph. And the linesman heard all about it, but wouldn't change his mind.
Buffalo 1, Toronto nothing. 1:55 remaining in the first period. Ward got the goal. Toronto gives chase in the Leaf zone. So does Pekka. Ward slides it away from in front of the net. Maple Leafs get it out to center, but the Sabres now are picking it up and checking more carefully, more closely. There's Thomas centering it. Sundin missed it. He was open on the short side. Rada feeds it behind the net. Thomas was in first. Sundin was was slow to move for it. And then Elise Burrard steps up. Dangerous position in there. And he got caught by Ward, who slapped it out. And he was caught in time himself. Maple Leaf Sundin didn't see the pass behind. Sabres went to the net. Burrard had a good move. Passed it over in front. Sanderson, who quickly snapped it right at the far corner. And Joseph made a big save.
Well, the Leafs objected to the fact that Michael Peck kind of at the time the whistle, and look at the cut on Gordy Grossinger's forehead. We have a... we've got a penalty coming up here to somebody. As Gary Gregson sprints and he gets a roughing call, and I think it's against the Leafs. Gordy Grossinger's got a nasty cut on the forehead. We have a standby linesman, Wayne Bonney, and he may be forced to come in.
Linesman Grossinger injured and receiving attention.
There's one place you'll always...
Thomas is in the box now for the Maple Leafs, and he was caught for this roughing.
Well, there was a skirmish. There's Gordy Grossinger, Jim Pizzitelli, the Buffalo trainer, trying to patch him up. And the question now is, can he finish the period 1:08? They're going to put a little bandage on it. They'll have a closer look to it in between periods. And there's Gordy Grossinger. Surely he's not going to do it with him holding it against his forehead. But he was really bleeding there. And anyway, Thomas picks up a roughing penalty well after the whistle had gone. So with 1:08 left, the Leafs are back into the penalty kill.
1-0 Buffalo. Power play now. Buffalo's goal is shorthanded. And the Leafs have the extra man. Ward scored it.
Last minute of play in this period.
Woolley fired a hard pass into the corner. Buffalo spread out. The five men outside. Turning with it at the line is Holzinger. Trying to get somebody open. Not as yet. It's cleared, but not out. It hit the boards and got as far as the line. And now the Leafs get it out there. Markov decides to keep going. Markov rolled a shot in.
The net is off.
That's the second time behind Hasek with 30 seconds left in the period.
Perreault just fired the Buffalo defenseman into the net after he was holding him and bothering. We didn't get a penalty, but Perreault didn't like it. And at the end of it, he just gives the Buffalo defenseman Schmelik a shove right here. Or sorry, Stu Barnes, who was back-checking into the crossbar, and the net comes off.
And the face-off is going to be inside the line. When the Leafs killing a penalty, that is a little bit of a help for Toronto.
The Leaf penalty killing has been pretty impressive so far, but you can't keep taking penalties to get away with it against this power play of Buffalo.
30 seconds left. Shots are 13-6 in favor of Buffalo. They win the draw. First item of importance for Buffalo. The time winding down in the period. Quick pass went wide. Markov is back to slice it away and into the corner. And Woolley fell. Dumped up there again. Slapped on the boards and Peck stopped it. For Woolley. To the line and just set. No shot goal. 4 seconds left. They have to go now with it. And they won't get a shot. Kenny turns as the horn goes to end the first period here at the Marine Midland Arena in Buffalo, New York. And the Sabres... and a shorthanded goal. And Don Cherry is standing by for our first intermission in the coach's corner. Ward is fifth of the playoffs from McKee and Hasek. The goalie at 16:15. After one, Buffalo leads 1-0.
Buffalo Sabres are up 2-1 in the series, 1-0 in game 4 here at Marine Midland Arena. The shots in that period, 13-6, scored. Brosker's fine. He's just gone back on the ice as well. Niagara Falls is 15 minutes away, where Rick Lee won 2 Memorial Cups, and Rick Lee is now with Scott Oak.
Rick, they double you up in shots in the first period, get a shorthanded goal. What are your concerns after the opening 20 minutes?
Well, I think we were ready to play, and obviously they were ready to play also. And what we have to do is we have to stick with our plan. We got to stay out of the penalty box. We can't take needless penalties and put the onus on our penalty killing. We got to stick to our plan and just keep working, keep the feet moving, and make sure we get it by their defense and force them to play in their end.
Are you happy with the way your team is answering their physical challenge?
We don't have a problem at all with our team. I mean, we've answered the bell all year, and that's not a problem for our team. We just have to keep working. I mean, a lot of people didn't expect us to be here in the beginning, so we've got great contributions from all our players, and we just have to dig a little deeper.
Thanks, Rick.
My pleasure.
Thank you, Scott and Rick. Buffalo Sabres have scored a power play goal in every playoff game. So a big situation for Toronto right now as we go back up to Bob Cole and Harry Neal. Bob.
Thank you, Ron. And 52 seconds left in the Leaf penalty as we start the second. 1-0. The Buffalo Sabres are ahead of the Maple Leafs. Sabres move up. That's Johnson forechecking on the penalty kill. He needs a big turn to get back as the Sabres get in deep. Will he center it? Joseph got the stick out to intercept that one. Jitnik at the line, and it's lost by Chatan, and down the ice it goes. Jitnik is the man back. 20 seconds left in the Leaf penalty. Pass on an open wing, and the Leafs pick it up. Holt shoots it away again. On the net by Jitnik. Willie moved it ahead. Leafs kill the penalty now. Thomas is back on with his shot. That's blocked. But the Sabres are in deep after it. He'll get behind the net. Toronto, move it out. Pass back off the boards. Thomas had to stop. Then he put it ahead. Bolt shot. That's blocked. Thomas is on it. Thomas, give it away in there. Trying to beat the man and go around the net. Sabres cut back. It's Brown. Gets in far behind the net and up the other side. All the way to the line, and Brown has it again. Trying to center it this time. Out himself. Centered it. And this shot by Pekka didn't miss by much. Pekka is bumped by Coverley. Bolt fell. Put the stick in there, though. Chatan comes out. He leaves it. Great pressure by Buffalo. They're all over the Maple Leafs here. Chatan again. Fanned on it. Broke his stick. Center ice. Lifted over the line. Dropped back to Thomas. What a save! Now is he slow getting up? He did a big stretch on that one. That's the best stop Dominik Hasek has made since the last round of the playoffs against the Boston Bruins. On a labeled shot. As you're going to see the pass from Barrison right here to Thomas, and he just wires it. The puck's rolling. He keeps it down, and it was a great stop. The Leafs' penalty killing has been much improved tonight. One of the reasons is they're getting right out on Woolley and Jitnik. Jitnik is number one in penalty and power play points in these playoffs, and there's a good example right there. And Woolley is tied for second. They have 18 combined power play points.
Face off at the Sabre zone. Sundin won it. That's Bohanas on the left. Domi is on there now with him, and it's offside. Domi got hit with a high stick on that play.
Well, Thomas came out of the penalty box and couldn't get off the ice. So he played a long shift as the man coming off, and that's why Domi's on the Sundin line right now. Kai Domi takes one right in the noodle from Mike Pekka. He'll stay out there as the right winger with Bohanas and Sundin. And I don't think it's any secret in the fact that Matt Sundin has got to play a lot better than he played in the first period if the Leafs are going to prolong this series or take a shot at winning it.
Leafs looking a little weary at times in that first period. And Buffalo were full of bit on Vinegar. Goalie is having a hit. Buck comes to the side of the goal. The Leafs scramble for it. Domi hit back then. He comes again. Domi kneeling Pekka, who lost the helmet. Domi took that stick a little high on the check by Pekka a little while ago. Now Pekka has it. center ice and knew what he was going to do. Took him about 5 seconds to get there, and then he nailed Berard. Boy, he's tough.
Mike Pekka, boy, what happens on these open ice hits for Pekka is he arrives about a stride sooner than you think he's going to. You think you're all right, and you look up, takes a hit right there from Domi. But here we come right here. Now watch Pekka. He gets the angle, and then he gets right there about a stride before Berard thought he was going to get there. That's a real knack. And the skill not many players in this business have, the ability to throw an open ice check.
Oh, he doesn't mind it at all. Apparently he loves it.
He weighs about 175 pounds.
I know. I saw him in the room the other day, and really, he's a slight hockey player, but tough as nails. It's scooped up to center ice by Groshen. In on the wing was Rasmussen. Center, and he scores! Olsinger with the speed. Buffy opening. 2-0 Buffalo.
Two horrible giveaways in game three, and Sullivan does it right here as he wants to go up the middle with it, and Holzinger is standing right there and walks in all alone on Joseph. Steve Sullivan wants the long pass to break out of the zone, did not check to see if anyone was in the passing lane.
Second Buffalo goal, his third goal.
Buffalo with a lead. Number 19, very, very tough to come back on. They're up 2-0 now. Toronto trying to get it back. Ashing the save on the short side. Alberezin. Volk is in with a hit. Juno scooped it out. And there go the Sabres again. Three of them are coming after two Leaf defensemen. In on the wing. Centered by Groshen. Took away. And the Leafs get a 3-on-2. They move it up to the line for McKee. Chopped it down. Berezin. He missed it. Rasmussen. Firing it in again. They're calling Cujo. They're on Joseph. But he was facing Holzinger in that last scoring play and didn't have a chance. Holzinger making it 2-0 for the Buffalo Sabres on this one.
Well, this was an attempted breakout pass by Sullivan. Holzinger forgot presented with the puck and put it in.
Unassisted, of course. Holzinger is third of the playoffs. 2:51 the time. Toronto in the hole against the Sabres. And Sundin is offside on that rush as Thomas passed it into him.
Well, this is a gut test for the Leafs. They need the next goal, and they need it pretty quickly. And this Buffalo team, one of the better teams at defending the lead. And if you get a little careless, you take too many chances. It'll be in your net. Real test for the Leafs.
Face off at the line, won by Sundin. They'll get it in, but the Sabres are coming back fast. Sundin in with a forecheck and a late hit. Nearly put the puck out in front. Buffalo shoot it down the ice, no icing. It's been waved off. Côté hurrying back as Joseph informed him on the wave off. Côté up to Sundin. Mohanis right behind him. He goes to the other side. And Coverley misfired. Buffalo again with 2-on-1. Wow. Verado's in front. Can't get the pass to him. Open up now. The Leafs have to open up. And they're coming in on the attack with Thomas. Driving a shot off the stick of Zhitnik. And high into the crowd.
Barata and Joseph, well behind the play, had more than just a conversation. Barata still talking to Berard. Here it is right here. Berard gets it. Oh, he gets the old separator from Joseph. He doesn't like it. makes a comment or two. The referee, you can see him looking at it. Let's it go.
And the faceoff will come now inside the Buffalo line. To the left of Hasher.
Hydomi just went over and had a little chat with Rob Ray. Let's see if it was a friendly one or a hostile conversation.
Here we go. Nearing the 5-minute mark of the second. Long shot. Doesn't reach the net. Doesn't get near it. Nor does this one. Domi got it out front, and the shot is blocked. And three Sabres rush away to center. The defensive play gets him down to the rush. Fired in deep by Barnes and around the net. They keep it in, too. Woolley at the blue line. Barnes has it. Fires it over.
This little tip that just bounces in by him. And that's his first point, and this is third playoff game. And a big goal on a tip that really wasn't a pass. It was a bit of a shot. And it bounces in, and this crowd is rising to salute Rob Ray.
Oh, they're standing now and roaring. Burns will get one assist for sure. Rob Ray makes it 3-0 Buffalo.
First in the playoff score by number 32, Rob Ray.
Chatan shoots. Score! It is 4-0, folks. 4-0, Buffalo.
Well, I mentioned when the Leafs get behind and they're playing a Sabre team. And Carpets have stood up at the red line and never could get back. You're going to see Carpets right here. And he's going to back up, then changes his mind. Now he's trapped. And away goes Grossi. And you can see Sanderson coming down the middle, and Chris King took his eye off him and let Sanderson get a half a step. And he just reaches out and changes the direction on this play right here on a rebound, and it's 4-0 Sabres, and they have the Leafs by the throat here in game number 4 of this series.
And the error, 4-0. We were just saying a moment ago it would be tough to come back on Hasek, and the Sabres down 2-0. Well, baby, now it's 4. Two goals in 22 seconds. Buffalo, 4-0. Well, the Leafs have been stung hard. Oh, not again. Sanderson, stopped by Joseph. Rebound, stopped by Joseph. Another big scoring chance for Buffalo. They just keep pouring it on.
I thought we watched the Avalanche last night, but this is a goal-scoring Avalanche, and this rink is in a frenzy, and the Toronto Maple Leafs are in deep trouble here in game 4. A giveaway right there by Barkov, and a blistering shot, and the rebound, and Joseph makes two saves on Sanderson first, and then on Grossman. And Joseph, who's been left all alone in this second period. The chances were 9-3 in the first. And it's heading for a more staggering statistic in this period.
Ray and Barnes and Woolley. Final back line was 5-0-4. Fourth Buffalo goal, his second of the playoffs, scored by number 80, Jeff Sanderson.
assist number 81, Miroslav Shatan. Number 37, Curtis Brown.
Shatan assisted on the fourth goal as the Leafs come on the attack now. Bolt went after it in front of the net. Sabres cover, and it's lifted up by Shunov. Rasmussen nearly had a break. Three goals in 2 minutes and 45 seconds here in the second period, and it is 4-0 Buffalo. That's a nice hit call against the Sabres. They haven't been able to touch the ship.
We now move ahead in the action.
Well, there are two Buffalo babes that are obviously very happy and feel they're going to go to the Stanley Cup final. Well, they're on the road now, but still lots of hockey left of this. Just past the halfway mark of the second period. It's 4-0 Sabres, and Hasek has not been too busy, not at all.
He's made a few good stops, but he looks under control. You never know. He was hurt. Not nearly as acrobatic as we normally see him. The Sabres have taken advantage of home ice here in the latter part of the schedule. The last seven home games, plus the first six in the playoffs, this being the seventh, the Sabres are 12-1 at Marine Midland Arena, and looks definitely like it's going to be 13-1 after this one.
Leafs have had about 11 shots in the hockey game, half the number of the Buffalo Sabres. The Sabres are ahead 4-0. McKee, a little touch pass from center to Holzer. He made two or three good moves in there to get away from three Leaf players. Then was hit, but got the puck in deep. Buffalo skate around with it, all the way to the line, now out. No, the weight. So Holzinger brought it in. Banked it off the boards behind the net for Rasmussen. He's bumped. Can't pick it up again. There's another giveaway. That's blocked this time. Toronto trying to get it going. Unable to get it going. And anyway, coming to center, Berard. Up for Volk Evenwerk. And now there's another break. Three Buffalo Sabres are on this one. Roshik had to stop, ripped in the shot through a crowd, and Joseph saw that all the way somehow and stopped it.
Well, the Leafs got trapped at the offensive blue line on a giveaway, and the Buffalo Sabres jumped on it. Their transition game is among the better ones in the league. Here goes Rob Ray. He's going to be the guy who wants to get this pass. He's in the clear, but you can see that Michael Groshek overskated the puck. Let's have a look at the three goals that have put the Leafs in deep trouble here in the second period. Sullivan up the middle to Holzinger. It's 2-0. And then a pass here. Rob Ray tips it in between his legs. It's 3. And then this shot here and the rebound by Sanderson makes it 4.
And the puck ending up off that faceoff on top of the net behind Curtis Joseph. So the play was stopped again. You saw those three goals that the Ruffs team put together. They came in 2 minutes and 35 seconds. The first two in 22 seconds. Bang, bang. 2:51 and 5:04.
Well, they got three goals in game three, Buffalo did here, in 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the second period. So the second period has been disastrous for the Leafs so far in this round in Buffalo.
After the 5:04 goal, it came at 5:26. That's the 22-second thing, but 2.5 minutes, just like that, the Sabres are way out front, 4-0. Goal in the first by Dixon Ward. That was a short-handed goal. Toronto up with it. Just can't. Trying to jam it in. Pushing along the goal line and cut it out. High stick made contact. It's okay, the lead player attacks it, Adams. So now Adams chases it. And it was in front of him. And Jason Woolley played it twice. Second time, cut it away from the lead player, Adams. Markov, ring wide for Chris King. pitch to Adams, who wants to skate. Got to center ice and dumped it in, and the Leafs are changing. 6:45 left of the period. All Buffalo and this one. 4-0 lead. Here in game four, it's picked across center by Chatan. Now he's up to break to the net. Chatan, great move, shoots. Johnson made a save, and a big play by Chatan. He made two or three terrific plays.
Chatan's a nifty hockey player. Missed nine games, played his first game in the playoffs since April the 25th. In game three, played 21 minutes. And as we suspected, he might feel even better tonight. And here he gives you a little demonstration of his skills as he pulls it by Steve Thomas. And Joseph has to make a spectacular stop to keep it at 4-0. Here's the look at it in the eyes of Curtis Joseph. There's the move on Thomas. And Chatan really doesn't get a lot on it. His son Dean's kind of half bothering from behind.
You have to see his 24th birthday. And what a talent. Great speed, good shot, good instinct. Joseph coming up big again right there. You're right, his team. Left him to do it himself in this period. He has been very, very steady. In the first period, made some big stops. And now in this second period, same thing.
Pat Quinn is a reluctant coach as far as pulling goaltenders. And he's got no reason to take Joseph out because he's played poorly. But I'm sure he's thinking, you know, if I put Healy in and save Joseph from going through the rest of this game, which may get worse by the look of it, he may be better, in a better frame of mind, when they go back to Toronto for game five. And he may do it after the intermission, where Healy gets a chance to stretch in the dressing room and get a little skate before he starts. I don't know, but I'm sure he's thinking of it.
6:14 away from that intermission now. Sabres comfortable, very comfortable. On the first game in Toronto, 5-4. The Leafs came back with a 6-3 win. Here comes Brown again. Joseph stopped that pass out to Sanderson, who's in front. Chatan again, turning, and Sanderson's shot blocked. Chatan again, good play. Well, he got a hit to Chatan again for setting that one up. A beautiful effort to hang on to it and then make the dandy pass. 5-0 Buffalo.
Now it's getting beyond the point of being anything but embarrassing for the Toronto Maple Leafs. They've lost their confidence completely. Joseph is holding them in, if you can say that, in a 5-0 game. But it's the men against the boys, and the men are up by 5 at the moment. Great shot by Sanderson, who's got one of the best shots in the league. Beautiful pass by Chatan to Sanderson and Joseph Noho. A bullet shot.
Second goal of the period for Sanderson. This one comes at 14-10. And it's a 5-0 lead.
Fifth Buffalo goal, his second of the game and third of the playoffs, scored by number 80, Jeff Sanderson.
Sanderson has come into his own in this series after floundering around, not doing very much. 3 points in three games, and he's got three more tonight.
Chatan, the only assist on the goal by Sanderson, his second of this game, and he set him up for the first one. Ian Brown did. That's the goal that made it 4-0. This is the goal that makes it 5-0. Johnson's pass inside his own line. Sullivan comes to center and shoots it in wide of Hasek. Johnson on the net, centered. Hasek down. Puck stays out. Overlay shot. Hasek is out of the net. Knocked it away behind the goal. The Leafs cause a little disturbance in there now. Hasek closing off that short side. Buffalo now take over and go down. Rasmussen cuts for the goal. It went through the crease. Rasmussen stays in there looking for it. It'll be Berard. Takes a hit from Rasmussen. Sullivan gets as far as center. That's all. And here's Johnson. He rolled it over in front of the net. And the Sabres are back. They don't clear it. Sullivan comes in. Shoots. Missed on the backhand. And then he was upended. And there's going to be a penalty. As Sullivan was dumped after taking that backhander. When we come back, the Leafs will go on the power.
Dixon Ward in the penalty box for the Sabres. Leafs have to go on the power play. Here's Sabres general manager Darcy Bergeron. Darcy, how do you account for this explosion?
Well, I think our guys really knew how important this game was to keep home ice advantage, and I think that's the biggest thing.
Do you trace this back to last game?
I do. I think we finally started to play our own game in the second period of the last game as opposed to reacting to the Leafs.
Thank you, Darcy.
Thank you, Scott.
Bob.
Thank you, Scott. Leafs on the power play, all right, and Sundin couldn't handle that pass. It bounced high, and Cote kept it in at the blue line for Sundin. Again, he's covered. The Leafs on the power play, 0 for 3. And only four shots on their three power plays. Sabres shoot it down the ice. Just ripped it. 40 seconds gone in the penalty to Ward. Kasha doesn't stop it. Leaves it there. Sabres play. Down the ice again. 4 minutes left of the period. 5-0 Buffalo. Big, comfortable lead. The Sabres have established in the second period. With a goal in the first, shorthanded by Ward, who's now in the box. And four goals here. Leafs in attack. He's got to be tough to beat. Long play down the ice for Holzinger. Took lots of time to kill more time. 40 seconds left in that penalty to Ward. Perreault brings it up. Left it at the blue line. Perreault again takes the pass. Cuts it back a bit. Open man was near the line. That's Sullivan. Flipped it ahead. And again from the blue line. Long drive, rebound. To the side of the net, no harm. The Leafs are at it though. Hasek against the post on this near side as Barn is all the way back. And Sullivan lost it against Juneau. And the penalty has 5 seconds left. So, Sabres have killed that off. Ward now on the ice. And on the puck. Dixon Ward steps over the line. Drifts it off to the left of Joseph. And the Leafs. Heads are spinning, no doubt about that, with the attack set on them by the Buffalo Sabres in this period. Goals in 2 minutes and 35 seconds. Two scores in just 22 seconds. They've added a fifth. Sanderson, number two in the period. 14-10. 2 minutes and 10 seconds left in the second period, which has been a disaster for Toronto. Sabres will take a 3-1 lead in the series unless the roof caves in. ACC in Toronto on Monday, 7:30 Eastern. All uphill now for Toronto with a minute and 45 left in this, the second period. Bischoff is coming in the center ice area just outside the Buffalo line. The Leafs have had 16 shots now on Dominic Hasek. He's been very careful. He's been very steady. He has been Dominic Hasek. No goals. There's another for you. Roll that behind the goal line. To the left of the net. Brown comes back to help. His own zone. Mayer went over there to pick it up. Couldn't find it. And away come the Sabres. Pass behind Sanderson. He and Chetan trying to bring it in. It's Toronto. It over the line, but the play on the Brown stick. Skates away from Bear. Played it up the center. Down across the line is Chetan. A trick or two to Sanderson. Up to the line. Brown can't get through.
That's the way.
Was in front of him. Gustafson looking for the third of the period.
27-17, Buffalo. The shots, the chances. And Dominik Hasek has not contested like he often is, but he looks sharp. And if he looks sharp to me, he must look sharp to the lead shooters. A half a dozen stops, you might say, that were of the difficult variety. No problem at all, at least the one that we can see, with the fact that his movement is impaired at all by that groin. And here's a good illustration as he goes from side to side, touching both posts with both feet. And a guy with the bad groin, he'd be screaming under those circumstances.
They saw him just inside. The Leaf line won by the Toronto Maple Leafs, and Cote leaves it for Komarov. Komarov to shoot it down the ice. He did that all right. Another icing call. Well, the other big series is on tomorrow afternoon again at 2 o'clock Eastern in Dallas, Colorado. And the Dallas Stars. That series, and Andy tied. Chris and JD will have all the action for you. That's Hockey Night in Canada, CBC, Richie, Game 5. Colorado and Dallas.
It's a great series, and anybody can win that one. It's a 2-3 now with Dallas and the home ice advantage.
Buffalo has outchanced Toronto in this period. This been is 15-8. And scored four goals. Well, that'll tell you something about Joseph. He's made some daddies.
And nothing wrong with Joseph's performance. He's an orphan out there today.
18 seconds left in this second period. Sure, the penalty was called.
I don't think a penalty is called, but he went piling into the boards as he tried to make the takeout. Hard to see who it is. Chris Broadhurst, the trainer, and Dr. Clearfield, the doctor, are already out there.
He's Lonnie Bahanas, is it not?
Yes, it is. He went to take the Sabre player out right in front of the Sabre bench and kind of went off the back of him and spilled into the boards in an awkward fashion. And not often do you see the trainer and the doctor out that quickly. So it's Steve Thomas, not Lonnie Bohannes. Thomas playing under less than...
Yeah, it is.
Less than 100% physically. Looks like he's all right, but he was looking for the takeout. Let's have a look at it here now. He missed Warner and then kind of tripped over the back of him and went into the boards in an awkward fashion right there. Lucky he got turned so he didn't go in head first. But we do know that he's playing less than 100% with an injury, as many players are, and those kinds of spills are not what you need when you're already unhealthy.
Buffalo leads Toronto 5-0. And only 10 seconds left of the period. 27-17. The Sabres are out shooting the Maple Leafs over two periods of hockey in this Eastern Conference final.
Every statistic you look at, Bob, turnovers, body checks, blocked shots, chances to score, shots on goal, they all tell you the same story. On the scoreboard, 5-0 Buffalo.
Sabres putting on a good show to take a 3-1 series lead in this Eastern Conference final. This period is done. Got something going near the blue line, though. Domi. There's a Bray tied up. And so, nothing developed. Period is over. And the Sabres are in command of this one.
Guy Domi challenges Rob Ray, but there's no percentage in Ray getting involved in anything with Ty Domi. They've fought 100 times, I think, in their career. So this invitation is turned down by Ray, but they won't all be turned down by him.
All right. The Buffalo Sabres are ahead of this one, 5-0.
We now move ahead in the action.
4:08 gone in the third period, still 5-0 Sabres. The Leafs have declared that Steve Thomas will not return tonight. Injury information guarded very carefully in the playoffs. It is known, though, that Thomas has been playing with a shoulder problem in his past few games. We could speculate that he aggravated the shoulder injury when he fell into the boards late in the second, but that's only speculation. Nonetheless, he will not return tonight, and the big question now is, will he be available in Game 5 when the Leafs will need him a whole lot worse than they need him in this period, Bob?
Well, Scott, he really went into the boards heavily. No question about it. He aggravated something. And let's hope that little aggravation. Steve Thomas has been a spark plug with this Toronto Maple Leaf team the whole season. Through with the playoffs. Pekka. Again, Healy. And a nice move with the stick to intercept the pass from Pekka. And ice again. Sabres can put her in cruise control now. Centering pass with Ward cruising in. Sundin gets to the line. Throws it through and passes to the bottom box now with the right pad on that. And Buffalo will get it out and down the ice. It's coming with 14 minutes and 54 seconds left. Game 5 coming up in Toronto on Monday at the ACC, 7:30 Eastern Time. The start. Stavich missed the net with a shot from the blue line. Sabres turn. Ray, who has a goal, his first goal in the playoffs, in this hockey game tonight. Stavich coming back. On a skate out. Rowe getting the center. And to the line where he loses it. We're sitting early tonight here in Buffalo. Joseph. They just kept pouring goals at him. And not much you could do about it. There were good, clean plays and good, clean shots.
Really think the Buffalo Sabres have worn down the Leafs physically with their body checking, especially by the Sabre forwards.
Kamerle shoots it in deep. That's Chris King on it first for Toronto. He just threw it to the Sabre on the goal line. And Brown just knocked it out. And stopped. Toronto trying to move it in. That's King again. But it'll be Jason Woolley. Deep pass. A good one. The center ice. The tan was back to centering it. Healy. Trying to see what Joseph saw in the second. 2-on-1 that time. Call again against Toronto with 13:37 left.
Well, the Buffalo Sabres with the return of Chatan automatically gave them a very dangerous offensive forward line that they went without for 9 games. He's one of those players that makes his teammates, his line mates look better. We've seen that already on 2 assists, and here's another example of his ability to find this line mate in the clear. And the guy that looks like he's enjoying it the most is Jeff Sanderson playing with Chatan.
Sabres come up after the Leafs again, forechecking hard. Johannes, rink wide pass, nobody down there, but he was there. Put it up the carpet set. Got it down the ice, no icing, waved that off quickly. But it's Rasmussen who picks it up and tried to skate away himself. Didn't take care of Johannes, who centered it. He hit the pads of Hasek. Hasek down again to throw it away. Look out, a penalty shot is being called. I do believe that penalty shot is being called against Hasek and the Buffalo Sabres.
And the Leafs will get the choice of anyone on the ice to take it. Matt Sundin is out there. He's already missed one in these playoffs.
Now this takes us right back Harry Tanagano, Japan. Dominic Hasek in a shootout. And we're going to find out who. Nobody's come from the Leaf Quintet yet. The referees are talking at center ice to the Buffalo Sabre, Holzinger. And he learns what it's all about. And it's called now.
They're going to try and get Sergei Berezin out to take it, but he wasn't on the ice when the play was called. But let's have a look at the play here.
Hand on the puck. There it is.
Right there. Wasn't on for very long, and Matt Sundin is the nominee. He's checking the puck to see if there's any chips in it. He doesn't want it rolling.
Well, Dominic is right on the goal line now in his crease. Left hand up on the crossbar. Right hand, the stick off the ice. And he's staring down at Matt Sundin, who's now picking it up. And let's watch. Hasek out. Beautiful shot by Sundin, that was. Hasek, he goes high on him over the blood, and Sundin gets a little bit of life into this Maple Leaf team. 5-1.
Well, any success is worth something to the Leafs, and Matt Sundin, who hasn't done much tonight, really makes a nifty play here. Watch this shot. He gets it up in a hurry, right over his glove. And the Toronto Maple Leafs, for the first time tonight, can feel good about something that happened. Sundin, with his head up, puts it up over Hasek. Where was that move in the Olympics?
Well, it wasn't with the team we wanted anyway.
But this guy was with the team we didn't
want. Was he ever? Well, you know, that's the first successful penalty shot in Maple Leaf playoff history.
I don't know if any player, we'd have to check the record book, has any player ever had two penalty shots in one playoff? Dean has, 1-2.
500, not bad. But not good tonight. It's a 5-1 hockey game. A goal by Sundin on a penalty shot coming at 6:59. Now Berard is trying to get in on that. Rolling out of the net, Berard fired it behind the net. There's Berezin. Saturday. Stopped at the line, and that bounces out. Sam couldn't keep it in. Through the middle of the ball. Into the pass to the net. And Hasek makes a brilliant stop. Yannick Perreault was set up perfectly. Chetan tried to go in. Berezin back in his own zone. Here's Healy out of the net. Berezin. Hard pass, it doesn't get too far. It was picked off in there by Chetan. Now he's caught. Stick knocked out of his hands by Junot. Sullivan nearly broke away. Hasek out again. And to Smelling takes it. Sullivan took it away from him. Trying to center it. Couldn't get the puck out to Adam Mayer. And Buffalo got it over the Leaf line. 5-1 game now. Sundin scoring on a penalty shot. Sullivan, nice pass. There, however, it was stopped. Roshek through the middle, and Johnson got back to take it away from him. Leafs all of a sudden are looking a little better with a crisp passing. Healy is out of the net. So Barnes coming up. Thought he better get out before Barnes could get near. Patrick pinching in. Shot it to the boards in the corner. And they hold it. Referee tells them to move it. They do. Groshek centering pass. It was Sullivan in front of Lynn Healy. And he got it out of there. 5-1 game. Buffalo ahead. Third period just about up to the halfway mark. Adams around the net. Skating well. Flip the pass through the middle, and King just missed it, and so did Sundin. Cote will have to come back with Coverle. Now down through center. And there it goes. Adams right in on goal. Oh! Hasek reached out the right arm and knocked it away from him. He had it deep. Long shot to Hasek. He found it. Took him a second or two. But it was right in the crease, right in front of him. He just made a big stop. He knocked it away.
We now move ahead in the action.
Face off to the right of the backup goalie, Ryan Healy. Came on in here in the third period to get Curtis Joseph a break. Harrison will bring him offside.
Well, if you're a Leaf fan, May 29th is not one of your favorite days on the hockey calendar. May 29th, 1993, Wayne Gretzky, in the seventh game, puts the Leafs out of any hope of return of going to the Stanley Cup Finals. The LA Kings beat the Leafs, and Wayne Gretzky, as he so often has, but this is a little bit different than most of his goals. It goes off the skate of Dave Ellett and goes in.
You know, talking to Wayne, thinking about all the series of games he played, as the Leafs come in, and it's cleared off Karostek easily. He calls that little clip you saw there, that game, that series, was his favorite of all time. Isn't that something?
He has. Anyway, May 29th is nearly over. The Leafs have got to start to focus on May 31st. Healy's done a nice job jumping in under adverse conditions. The Buffalo Sabres are not forechecking like they did in periods one and two. They're just making sure nobody gets trapped. And Curtis Joseph, on a rare occasion, watches the third period of a game he started. But it isn't because he didn't play well. They're trying to get him in the best possible shape for game number five.
He had 27 shots in his two periods.
Referees over at the timer's bench talking to him about something. I don't know what the problem is. It appears to be corrected as they're ready for the faceoff.
He has had just one shot so far in this third period. Set with a few passes in his crease area that might have ended up being a shot, but did not because of his quick moves. They want Barnes to get a goal now. You hear him holler stew when he's on the ice, and more especially when he takes the puck, and now he's got it. Listen to him. Trying to get his goal, Healy on the short side. Dumped it out front, and the Leafs pick it up and get it ahead. Sullivan had to stop to pick it up. Then they rolled the pass ahead. Now, Joseph nearly gone going. But out the helmet is Chris King, and he lifts one into the Buffalo zone. 6:55 left. Buffalo will go on 3-1 in the series just by hanging on now in this one. Domi went in to grab his man. Did grab his man. The play continues. How the Sabres get it out down the ice. Markov behind the net. Now you skate. Sundin didn't know the pass was coming. Petka flipped it a little short one in there. And Ward tried to get inside. Covered on the post on the short side. Ward and Virata nearly get another one for Buffalo. Healy stopped it.
Virata nearly scores the sixth goal as he cuts in from an impossible angle, and the puck got in behind Healy, but he sat on it.
Hote and Coverley, the defenseman, together. They started the play, and that's broken up at the Buffalo line. They shoot it down the ice. Nice thing coming up. With 5:53 left.
Well, the shots are 9-3 for the Leafs in the third period. Score 5-1 Buffalo. And Glenn Healy, who's playing the third period, makes an awkward but effective save right here. As it was awful close to being in the net in the air. But Healy, who's sitting on the goal crease, catches the puck, keeps it out.
He has been a great guy as a backup man for the Maple Leafs. You know that Curtis Joseph, most of the time, will start the games, and most of the time will start in the games. He's won some for the Leafs this year. But he couldn't do it tonight. The this Buffalo team four marks. They came out hitting, skating, passing well, shooting, everything. Only thing they did get tonight, so far anyway, is a power play goal. They've done that at least once in every playoff game this season. Now the puck is knocked down to the lead line again. 5:25 left to play. Brard, get a shot through there. His pass is easily intercepted. Careful with that one. Pretty good pressure by this line for Buffalo. Ultimo, Juno, and Rasmussen. Berard will have to get the end with Rasmussen now. Could get it out. Holzinger. Rasmussen behind the goal with it. Trying to flick it through his skates and out to hit the back of the net. He's on it again. Around the goal. Out front, in the slot. And finally foul. Trying to move up on it. Hero's long pass out of the reach of Pearson. Toronto. 4:32 left in the third period.
Well, this is a popular night for the Buffalo Sabres fans. Fortunately, they're not typical ones.
Nice now.
I'd be dancing too if my team was up 5-1, one game away from the Stanley Cup final. Doesn't make you dance in this business, nothing.
Some of the crowd figuring they've had enough, they've seen enough. The game should be won by Buffalo, and they're getting a head start on the traffic leaving this Marine Midland Arena in upstate in New York. Buffalo.
Well, there was a significant number of Leafs fans here, but they've become as silent as the Leafs goal scorers
have. Matt Sundin, the only goal scorer for Toronto in this game with only 4:26 left, and he got that one on a penalty shot back at 6:59. That made it 5-1.
Stop into Canadian Tire for everything you need to get your car back on track. Canadian Tire, still the right place to do it.
Ruff and his assistants, Mike Ramsey and Don Lever, have done an exceptional job with this Buffalo team in the last 2 years.
That's Chetan. Boy, he's having a great night handling the puck against Ivan. Made a couple of dandy setups. And the Leafs pick it up. Under 4 minutes left now. Up the center. Tried to sweep it in. Ohana's played it back. And there's Sundin around the net. Centered it. A chance here. And the shot is off Hasek's shoulder, I think. It went up over the net. Leafs keep it in. Ohana's had that big chance. And he's after the puck, but he's not down. The penalty will come on that takedown. Buffalo will have to kill off a penalty now. The Leafs come back on a power play. Stand by.
Whatever your game, there's one place you'll always score big. Canadian Tire. Still the right place to do it.
Curtis Brown gets the penalty. And with 3:33 to go, the Toronto Maple Leafs will get a power play.
Brown, 2 minutes for obstruction to bay.
He tripped the lead players, Bohannes, as he was trying to get behind the net to recover a loose puck. Let's have a look at the penalty here. And there's the trip right there. So Bohannes would have won the race to the puck, but was tripped.
This is the fifth power play of the hockey game for Toronto. How many shots have they had? Six. From the blue line, Berard. Chopped it to the corner, all right. Sullivan missed it. It's high over the boards near the Buffalo bench. As a matter of fact, into the player's bench. And a faceoff will come to the left of Dominic Hasek.
Well, it's Toronto Police will leave right after the game, go back to Toronto, and they'll work out tomorrow in Toronto, and Buffalo will practice here and take the bus to Toronto around 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, getting ready for Monday's fifth game of this series, and the Leafs will be down 3-1.
And that game is at 7:30 Monday evening Eastern Time. Hockey Night in Canada on CBC, the full network. Game 5. Puck into the crowd again. 3:18 left. Big second period by Buffalo in this one. And that was curtains for Toronto. They scored 4 times. Two goals in 22 seconds.
Sanderson has really come to life in these playoffs, and especially late in the playoffs. Time 40 goal scorers. Goals production has dipped badly the last 3 years, but he's beginning to get the bomb sights honed up again.
It was that span of 2:35 when they got the 3 goals that did the Leafs in. They poured everything properly. Joseph, beautiful pass, breakouts, odd man rushes, and just simply great shoots in on the goal. Leafs trying to get another one, but they won't. Dominic down, slow getting up again. We noticed. Carr stopped at the line. Karpatsev just threw it up the dome. Break line behind Pearson. So he has nothing to do but shoot it in. There's Hasek out to stop it for.
It was the second attempt, and Matt Sundin found the puck, kicked it up to his stick, and snapped it in. And I don't think Ty Domi's going to get an assist, but he got Big Schmelik right in the way of Dominic Hasek, and he never did see that shot.
I wonder if that first shot didn't hit Domi, did it?
I don't know whether it got through or not, but it came right back. Let's have a look here. Here's the first shot. Looks like it hit Schmelik, and the rebound came right back, and then he snapped it up over Hasek.
Well, Sundin got the goal. We know that. 5-2, 18:03, the time of the
second
goal.
Second Toronto goal, his second of the game, and eighth of the playoffs, score number 13, Matt Sundin. Assistant number 28, Ty Domi, and number 42, Kevin Adams.
Domi did get an assist.
Domi and Adams, a
and
power
Adams
play goal, and
also got an assist. 18:03. Power play goal for Sundin. Second of the game. The other one on the penalty shot earlier in this period. Minute and a half left now. Sundin in there again. Sabres will clear it out and down the ice. 1:15 to go. Domi touched it. His skate was on center. It's onside. Leafs get a hold of it again, and it's Berard coming out. He was shooting.
Last minute of play in regulation time.
Second pass through the crease in the final minute of this game. Another shot for Hasek, and this time he had a little trouble with it, but got down quickly and held it.
Chris King got a shot away in a hurry after the Buffalo defenseman kind of lost the puck, and it surprised Hasek. He made the save. I'm not sure it was a calculated one. Let's have a look at it here. He missed trying to tip that one in, and he was in behind Hasek, and then here's where he's going to recover the loose puck and snap it right away. And Hasek made the save and then pounced on the puck. Dominic Hasek for an NHL goalie doesn't catch many pucks. chop slots, but doesn't catch as many as most goals.
There's one from Berard. He doesn't catch that. He stopped it with the right pad. That was a decent shot by Berard from the point. Sabres barely get it out. Johnson lost it just outside the line. 30 seconds left. Buffalo Sabres are taking a 3-1 lead in the best of seven series, this Eastern Conference final, for the right to go on and battle for the Stanley Cup. They'll meet the winner of Dallas, Colorado, who will play tomorrow with their series tied at 2, and that'll be on CBC2. Celebration is on, and it's a sad night for the Leaf hierarchy, but a big night for Lindy Ruff and his Buffalo Sabres.
Well, in the first two periods, they were clearly the best team, and in the third period, it was a question of them just trying to kill the period off. Toronto came to life slightly, and the question is, can Toronto regroup? They've done it lots of times this year, but this is not an easy team to do that again. And they can smell the finals in the Buffalo Sabres.
Sabres 5, Toronto 2. You are watching Hockey Night in Canada, brought to you by Labatt Blue.